Guys, so yeah, I think we are good to start our session. So once again, I welcome you all to our session for HR Transform HR Efficiency with Microsoft 365 Copilot. That's a practical use cases. We will focusing more on the practical use cases. So I welcome you all. So let's start the session. It's good to know what we are going to discuss in next 1 hour. So what we are going to learn is, first of all, we will try to learn what is Copilot. What is Copilot 365? What is the purpose of using it? What is the functionalities of Copilot? Then we will quickly move on to what is working principle with it. Then what are the core components and how we can enable the Copilot capabilities. In this case, what licenses you would be requiring. We will quickly check those, and then we will move on to our today's agenda, that is practical use cases, like how you can create a job description using Copilot and how you can analyze the resume. Let's say if you have a couple of resumes and your colleague, somebody has sent it to you. So how you are going to analyze those and how you can recommend them. How your Copilot can be useful in the words in those session. Once you have a job description, you have resume ready with you. Now you are ready to prepare the interview questions. So in Microsoft, there is a application name as a loop. How you can use Copilot with them, how you can create the question using loop. Then once you have the loop ready, then how you can go ahead and compose an email using Microsoft 365 Copilot in Outlook. So that's what our agenda is for today. And before starting that, it's always good to know about your trainer, who is going to train you. Let me start the camera as well. So that's me. My name is Abhishek. I'm a Microsoft certified trainer. I'm working with a corporate trainer with Koenig Solutions currently. I have more than 8 years of experience working in different Microsoft technologies. As I started my journey working on the productions where I used to take care of Azure Cloud, Microsoft 365, security, privacy, and compliance. I'm a Microsoft cybersecurity expert as well. I have some certification, expert level certification in Microsoft 365 and cybersecurity. So that's all about me. And now let's start our session with introduction to our Microsoft 365. So what is Copilot for Microsoft 365? So Microsoft Copilot is like a smart friend who's always ready to help you. It's powered by AI, which means it can understand what you are saying and it can help you work more efficiently. It can even make your work more enjoyable. Copilot uses something called large language model to understand your request, and it can give you helpful responses. It also uses data from Microsoft Graph, which is a service that provides access to the data within Microsoft 365. This makes Copilot responses even more relevant to your work and organization. And Copilot wo can work well with the daily user's application, like it can work with Teams, Word, Outlook, PowerPoint, Excel. It can do a lot of things, like summarizing a long thread in Outlook. It can turn a text-heavy slides into a clear bullet point in PowerPoint. Copilot can write a paragraph in different tones or a style that you will give in Words. And even you can summarize the meeting and chat threads in Teams. So in simple terms, Copilot for Microsoft 365 is like a smart coworker who's always there to help you work more efficiently, and you can always bring on your creativity as well. So that's what Copilot is. In simple and easy terms. So what is this is a continuation of it. Be Copilot ready. So to use Copilot for Microsoft 365, you will need to meet some of the requirements. First thing first, subscription part. You have to get a subscription, the basic subscription. Either for the example, you could have E3, E5 for enterprises, A3, A5, business standards, business premium, some of the licenses you should be having. Yeah. Once you have the licenses, basic prerequisite would be you require Microsoft intra-ID based account that is required for authentication. So if you want to check the licensing requirement, guys, I will be sharing a link quickly with you. Let me show you that, and I will be sharing that link so that you guys can check by your own as well. So this is the link where what I'm going to share with you. It states what is the Copilot requirement would be. In this, what are the prerequisites for application, intra, teams, all these things are listed in this. And in case if you want to check the licensing part, you can click on this, and this is the base license at least you should have so that you can use the Copilot. On the once you have the base licenses, on the top of this, you can buy the Copilot licenses. So let me share this links with you. Sik, is this with you only? Guys, what about others? Am I audible? Am I loud and clear? Let me turn off the camera. It could be bandwidth issue. Okay, you hear well. Okay, guys. So Sik, I think this is the issue with you. Kindly rejoin the meeting. It could be... okay, you can hear. Okay, guys, thank you for the confirmation. In that case, if... guys, those in case if somebody is having issue, kindly rejoin it. So it's okay. Let's continue with, from where we were. So at least you should have a base licenses so that you can get a Copilot. Let's say if you got a licenses on the top of this, once you have the licenses, you can buy the Copilot. Some more prerequisites that is already listed on that page would be what you require. You require intra-ID. So you will need an account based on Microsoft Intra for authentication. As we are talking about Microsoft 365, in Copilot, there are different licenses as well, like Copilot Pro, there is Copilot for Sales. There are a lot of things. As we are talking about Copilot for Microsoft 365, there are these kind of licenses that would be required. And ensure that OneDrive account is set up to allow Copilot to collaborate on your content. And we require new Outlook for integration. Let's say if you want to use Copilot in the Outlook, you require new Outlook application. Otherwise, you can use the web version as well. That's completely fine. Then a few more things. So Copilot for Microsoft 365 is an intelligent partner. It can enhance your productivity across different applications. It can understand your context. It can analyze the content such as any document. It can analyze emails. It can analyze your discussion that you have in the Teams meeting. It can understand your intent and meaning. So it leverages your work data in Microsoft 365 to provide any additional context. And it can take actions. What kind of actions? Search and retrievals. Copilot uses powerful search capabilities to find relevant data and content sources. You can use your own natural language. That's how we can talk to our colleague, our friend, our family members. We just ask them in the natural languages and they respond. Same with the Copilot. It can help you in writing assistance. It can help you in presentations. It can help you in data analysis visualizations. It can help you in security and compliance. It can help you in your controls. Copilot can be helpful in many ways. But how it works actually, the question comes to your mind. Basically, we inputs. That's how it works. We input our information. It could be from any of application, Word, PowerPoint, Excel. We give the commands, or we can say we give the prompt. So what it does, Copilot uses Microsoft Graph. So Microsoft Graph has all kind of data that we have, Teams data, group data, calendar, all kind of data that we have in, is integrated in Copilot. And based on that, in case if you have asked any relevant question based on these applications, it will respond to you accordingly. Yeah, so that's the simple architecture of Copilot, logical architecture, I would like to say. But again, there are some more terms that is involved in Copilot. You might be hearing around them from your colleagues, or let's try to simplify what are they. So let's understand some foundational element that is involved in Copilot for 365. Then we will move on to our use cases. First, LLM. LLMs are like a kind of artificial intelligence that are really good at understanding and creating the text that sounds like it was written by a human. They are called large because they have a lot of parameters, which are like their model's brain cell, and they are trained on a lot of data. We have LLM like ChatGPT. It's a kind of AI that can create the new content. So in case of Copilot for Microsoft 365, LLMs are the engines that powers it. These models are hosted privately by Microsoft Azure OpenAI services. And these are secure. Microsoft keeps your data separate from everyone and secure. This means your data is kept private while it is being processed and it is stored as well. Some more terms you might be hearing around Copilot would be NLPs. So NLP is knowledge process, language processing. It's like a kind of artificial intelligence that can help computer understand and respond to human language. It's like a brain behind Copilot. It can help you, Copilot, in reading, understanding, and creating the text like a human would. There are some components that are being involved in NLPs are tokenization, semantic analysis that makes a complete NLPs. And then we have Microsoft 365 application through which we give Copilot questions or might be prompts. And then we have Microsoft Graph. So basically Microsoft Graph is like it's a kind of big web that connects all your Microsoft 365 services. It is being used by Copilot to search and bring together content from different sources within your organization. So Microsoft Graph API can help Copilot understand more about you by bringing information from emails, from group, from chat, documents, meetings. Even they include data from Outlook, OneDrive, SharePoint, Teams. So you don't have to switch between different applications and navigate away. Microsoft Graph brings all the relevant information to you through Copilot. And don't worry, it's secure. Copilot only uses the information that you have permission to access. In simple term, Microsoft Graph is like a big web that connects all your data. It's like a smart assistant that uses your data to help you find the information you need. And Copilot, that is we are currently discussing, it's like a smart assistant that uses a chat format to interact with you. So that's different components of, I would say, different components of Copilots, how it works, just a small understanding of it. Now, let's guys, give me a quick minute. If somebody can't hear that, let me respond to him. Yes. So let's continue from where we were. Now let's talk about what application you guys use. Let's hear from you guys first. So tell me what application you guys use on a daily basis. I'm talking about M365 application, or what you use is like you use Word, Excel, PowerPoint, you use Outlook, you use Teams. Which application you use on the day-to-day basis? Or I would say mostly uses on the day-to-day basis. MSS and PBI, is it a third-party application, Arsene? OneNote, okay. Lucas, yeah, OneNote is also an application, great application. MS packages. Okay. So that's great, guys. Teams, yeah, that's true. We use Teams for meetings or a lot of things. Word and Access, yeah, that's true. Now let's talk about how we can use our Copilot inside those applications. As this is going to be a 1 hour session, so we will be only talking about few application. Like I will try to cover Words, Loop, Outlook, and in case if I get time, I will cover more applications as well. So you guys can see where we were talking about. Let's start with, let's say if you are an HR working in an organization, and now you want to create a job description using Microsoft 365, Copilot, and Words. So first of all, Microsoft 365 Copilot in Word is an AI-powered writing assistant that can help HR professionals streamline their work processes and improve their productivities. Copilot can assist HR professionals in various ways, like automating the resume screening. It can help you in job description assistance. It can help you in efficient onboarding. It can help you in employee feedback analysis. And there are a lot of things Copilot can help you in Teams. Let's take an example for that. Let's say you are an HR manager at a graphic design institute. Here, we will going to take a name of a fictitious organization. Organization is, let's say, Graphic Design Institute. Yeah, so you wanted to start the hiring processes for a new senior animation designer, and your staff created a document that outlines all the job responsibility for this role. Now you want to use the Copilot in Word to create a job description based on the job role responsibility in this document. Let's say I am currently into my, I have logged into my M365. Now I will go to Word so that I can start with that. So what we have for now, my team has created a graphic design Institute design team responsibility. Let me download that and then we will talk about this. So let's say my team has created this job responsibility. Yeah. Now, being an HR, what we can do, we can go to our Word. So how we can use, let's me start with the blank documentation over here. So Copilot is now integrated with your M365 inside your daily users application like this. Let's say I will give a prompt to Copilot. What I'm going to give, let's see, I'm the HR manager at Graphic Design Institute. We are currently starting the hiring process for a new animation designer. Please review the attached document that outlines job responsibility for the role and create a job description and on those responsibilities. What I'm going to do, let me get that one for you. Now I will attach the file that I have, the job description that I have just now downloaded. See if I have. Graphics Design Institute job description. Let me use this one. I have attached the file and I have given, okay, I'm the HR manager. I want to create, I'm hiring for a process of senior animation designer and create a, do this for me. So if you will notice within a few seconds, Copilot will start writing it for me. Senior graphic design role at Graphic Design Institute. What is the job responsibilities and the requirement that we have? Yeah. Although, if you will look at the bottom, there is an option whether I want to keep this one. If I'm happy with what it is, if I do not, I want to regenerate it. I want to create another draft. Within seconds, Copilot will create another draft for me. Yeah. So let's say if I want to edit something, I can go ahead and edit this. If I'm happy with this, I can keep it. I can regenerate. I can delete it. In case if I want to fine tune it, let's say if I'm happy with this one, this one looks good to me. Everything looks good. The documentation, research and testing looks good to me. But I want to change something inside it. I do not want to change the complete draft, but something. I want to fine tune it. I will give Copilot a response. What I have given, this job description is better, but it lacks the detail that I'm looking for in the job description. Be specific as you can, and I will give it one more try, and Copilot will refine it once again. See, research and documentation. Within a few seconds, I have three drafts ready with me. The first draft, this is the first draft with me. I can go ahead and check it. If I want to compare with the second one, I can go ahead and compare it with the second one. In case if I want to check it, the third one. Yeah. If I will compare it, let's say this third one looks good to me. What I will do, I will keep it. Now I have senior animation design position ready for me. What I will do, I will save it. Senior animation design role at Graphic Design Institute, or let me name this as HR, and I will give it today's date. Now this is auto-saved. Now I have a job description ready with me. Now, if I have a job description ready, next I want to do is I want to analyze the resume and make a recommendation using Microsoft 365 Copilot in Word. Now, let's see. Now, what we are going to do next is, let's say if I'm the HR manager at Graphic Design Institute, we have started a hiring process for a new senior animation designer. Our staff has created those documents. Now I have this job description ready with me. Now I want to start screening a batch of resume that we have received for this role. And we want to provide a recommendation as to which of this following candidate qualifies for the job interviews. So, in this case, let's say if I have some of the resume ready with me, if I will show you some of the resumes in the OneDrive. Let's use some of the HR resumes and see. I have some resume for Alex, I have for Holly, I have for Nestor, I have for Patty. Now I want to compare based on the job responsibility that I have. I want to compare these four of them. So let's start this. I will start from the scratch. Blank document. I will be starting from here. Now inside this, what I am going to do, going to give, I am going to give another prompt. What prompt I am going to give? I'm the hiring manager for Graphic Design Institute. We are hiring for the position of senior animation designer. Please create a report that compares the attached resume to the requirement of senior animation designer in the attached job description role and rank the candidate from most qualified to the least qualified. So guys, the more clear prompt you will give, the more clear job description or whatever the, your Copilot will respond to you accordingly. Now I'm going to attach my job description and I'm going to attach my CVs. Let's say if I have resume for, I am going to first of all attach for Alex. I'm going to attach a few more. I'm going to attach for Holly. But see, there is a limitation in currently in Copilot in Microsoft Word. You cannot attach more than three documents. Include three references, you can attach it to the maximum. Now, in case if you want to attach more than that, or in case if you want to compare more than that, what you have to do, first compare two of them, then save this file, then compare other two. So I'm going to compare two of them based on this document. So based on that, the information that I have given, Copilot has started comparing those two resume for me. Yeah. Now, in case if I want to compare the other two, what I have to do? I have to save this file, candidate comparison report that is already being saved, and I will start a new one and I will give a prompt. Okay, Copilot, there is a job description. There are two candidates and I'm giving two more. Go ahead and compare based on those and it will compare all the four of them. Okay, let's do that. Let's try to create this. Now, let me open a new file. Let's say I'm opening with a new document, blank document this time. Oh, sorry, I have to keep it. I will keep it. And Copilot will save it again. And now I am giving another prompt. Please create a report that compares the attached resume to the prior resume and create a comparison and rank the candidate from most qualified to the least qualified. So what I am going to do, I am going to compare those the comparison report that I have, and I am going to attach two more resume this time, and let's see how it works. Guys, still with me? I'm going to compare this time Nestor, and I will attach one more resume. This is with me is Patty resume. So based on the resume that I have attached and two initially I have given, Copilot will create a report this time with comparing all the four of them. See, now the job description, it has started comparing Alex, Holly, Nestor, Patty, and then now it started, it's giving me the comparison between ranking of the candidate for this one. Alex, with extensive experience, strong leadership team, Alex is the most suitable guy for me. Nestor then comes with over 25 years of experience, and based on that, it has given me conclusion at base on that. Based on the comparison of the candidate, it is recommended that consider Alex Wilbur as a top choice for this one. Yeah. So this way, how you can use Copilot in Word, where you can compare different candidates or whatever your need is. So this is how you can use, even see at the right hand side, there is one more Copilot that is written over here. You can ask Copilot here to summarize this document. Let's say if you have the long document, you can ask to summarize. You can ask him to create an image for you. You can understand something, summarize something. In case if I want to summarize this document, what it is, I do not have the time. So Copilot will summarize for you. Let's say, guys, if I ask a question that is not part of this document, let's say if I ask a question, what is the recipe of cheesecake? I love cheesecake, guys, so I will ask a question. What do you guys think? Will it give me the response? As this is not part of this document. Yes. Any responses? Nope. Okay. Morgan, thank you. What else? Others? Can Copilot suggest us when psychometric test will be suited for a specific role? You can try. You can give it a try. I would suggest you. I will not get into those kind of tests. I'm not sure what psychometric test is all about. You can give it a try. I believe it can. But although even Copilot has some limitations, but I'm not sure. Psychometric test, I'm not sure about that. So, guys, let's say if you ask a question that is not part of this document, Copilot will still give you a response for that. It's not like you, it's not part of the document. You cannot ask the questions. Here is the cheesecake ingredients that you require, and Copilot will give you the responses. Although, if I will ask a question based on this document, it will give me the response as well. So that's an added advantage for me. I can compare it. I can ask question. I can create different draft. I can create add an images for that. That's how we are going to use on day-to-day basis in HR. Now, if we have analyzed the resume and now we are ready to interview the candidates. We have four candidates. We have suggested, let's say, two of them. Now we are going to we are going to interview them. Guys, anybody has used loop? Loop. You guys know what is loop is? Meanwhile, I'm opening the loop solution. Are you guys using loop solution? Okay. Let me retry. First of all, let me give you what actually the loop is. I would say loop is a solution. Microsoft 365 Copilot in the loop is a very powerful tools that can help you and your team collaborate more effectively and efficiently. With Copilot in loop, you can create workspaces, you can use pages, you can use intelligent search and templates to add relevant content, and you can share your work with others. Copilot in the loop can help you suggest ideas. It can help you start projects. It can make you easier to get going where you find yourself stuck. It can create your draft. It can help you in creating tables. It can help you in generating codes, tech projects, and even answer your question quickly. So basically, Loop is a collaborative platform. Now I want to use Copilot in the loop so that me and my team can. Let me start naming this. This I am naming as a training, or let's name this as a something fruitful. Let's name this as any suggestions? What I should name this? Let's name this an interview question, as we are going to interview the as we are creating this loop for interview questions, I can add the members in my team. So me and my team can collaborate on this that file simultaneously. So if I want to add workspace, I am skipping. Now this is my loop workspace got created. Now how I can use Copilot inside the loop? Here it is. Use Copilot or just start typing. So here it is also. I can simply click it and I can give loop whatever command I want to give it. So let's say I will give 15 interview questions for the senior animation designer role. And I will hit enter. Oh, sorry, it's a Copilot over here. Let me rewrite it. What Copilot will do, whatever your response will be, Copilot will create a 15 interview question for senior animation designer role for you. Even you can share with your team. So in case if you and your team want to change anything on the real time, they can do that in the real time. Even you can see who is currently changing it. Let's say if I have given the prompt now. Like, can I change those prompt? Can I refine it? I can rewrite with the Copilot as well. Like, this create a list of 15 interview questions that should be asked to candidate applying for a new animation designer role at the Graphic Design Institute. And it will create it for me. See, this is the question. In case if I want to refine it, I want to check the old draft, all this is ready for me. Now, if I want to share, I can share with my team. I can share the page link. Let's say if I am sharing with someone. Let me open my another account. If I will share it with someone, at the top, it will show you who is currently accessing this file. Currently, it is only accessed by this Copilot page. Now, if somebody else is also accessing that file, at the top, it will show you. Okay, right now, we have two members who is accessing it. If let's say somebody want to change something. See, at the bottom, it will tell you, okay, this person is writing something. This is Copilot webinar. That's how you can collaborate and you can create the questions on Copilot loop so that you and your team can collaborate and they can work on the same file together. In case if you want to edit something, let's say if this is over here, if you want to edit, you want to create something, you can ask Copilot and Copilot will do it for you. Now, as we have gone through the loop, now our next process is how we can use in the Outlook. So I hope everyone is using Outlook. So what's our next task is we will be using Outlook for sending an email. Let me log in. Yeah. So now as we are ready as an HR manager for Graphic Design Institute, we have completed the interview process. We have selected our top candidate. Let's take an example. I have selected my top candidate as in Patty Fernandez. We are now ready to make Patty an offer for the position of senior animation designer. What I can do, I can start create. I want to write an email. Now, once I will be sending an email to the Patty, I want to attach a document for graphic or graphic designers to employee benefit for that. So what I would do, I will simply go ahead and attach from the OneDrive. What was that? employee benefit. Here it is. Let's go with employee benefit. And I will go ahead and attach this. Now this has been attached. Now I want to write an email to Patty about what I want to say, that you can use Copilot. See, at the top, we have Copilot and draft with the Copilot. And over here, I can give a response to the Copilot. Okay, I'm the HR manager as Graphic Design Institute. Please create offer letter for Patty Fernandez that offers a position of design animation designer. That start date is, I will put the start date and the salary starting is this. And a note, if Patty accepts offer, she must sign return the attached PDF. Which PDF? This is the PDF that I have. So I will simply go ahead and ask Copilot to generate it for me. It has been generated. If I'm not happy with something, I want to add something. First, here is an option. If I want to make it longer, I can just few clicks, it will make the emails longer for me. If I want to make it more formal, make it sound like more formal, I'm sending to someone, I want it to be a formal email. Hi, Patty, I trust this email finds you well. All these things has been added. Yeah, even I can make it more casual. I can make it more sound like more poem, shorter, whatever I want to. And at the top, you can see I have 3 drafts ready with me. I can go ahead and compare those 3 drafts. I can see which one fits for me. And I can, once I am ready with it, I can simply go ahead and send it to you. Now, let's say I want to put the date. The date is still blank. I am happy with this draft, but I want to change the date. So what I would do, instead of changing the whole draft, I will refine it. Put the date on, let's say, December 1st. So instead of me going to create the complete thing, the joining position is 1st of December. In case if I want to retry it, again, I want to create a draft for me. It will create a draft. Okay, Patty, your joining date is this, your starting salary is this. And I can ask, I can add, I can, whatever I want to refine it within the few minutes, I can do that for me. This is one of the way. There are a lot of things, even Copilot offers. Let's say if this is the email, if I have a long email, large email that is coming on. I want to summarize it. I do not have the time to read the complete email. Instead, I will ask, okay, Copilot, scan this email, and Copilot will go ahead and insert what are the important dates, whatever these things will be included. I can ask Copilot as well over here. Let's see, Nicholas is doing something. I want to check the summary of this. Do I have to go through all the email? No. Copilot will give me all the important things that are inside the email. Important emails, important dates, anything. This is some of the things that Copilot can do inside the Outlook as well. So now we are ready. We have a Copilot in Word. We have a check the loop. We have offered Patty the offer letter. Now we are good to go. That's what our day-to-day basis is. It's not like Copilot only offers in these. Even you can ask Copilot in the PowerPoint. So whatever the application you are doing using in day-to-day basis, I can ask Copilot in the over here as well. Let's say that I'm using the presentation. If I want to create a presentation, I can use that from the starting. Let's say if I want to create a presentation about employee benefit. What Copilot will do, within seconds, he will give me all these things, what they are going to create it, and it will start generating the slides for me. This is the blank one, like in case you have given a vague prompt for them. In case if you have any files ready with you, let's say if I have the employee benefit file, I can give to Copilot, okay, Copilot, using these file, create a presentation for me. Will Copilot will create it for me? Yes. So let's say if I have given the vague prompt, Copilot and employee benefit things, what Copilot will do? Copilot will start creating agendas, employee benefits, and once it is ready, it is creating my presentation, applying a design, and within few seconds, my presentation is ready. This is what Copilot has created for me. In case if I want to create, okay, I can ask Copilot, okay, Copilot, add a slide about agenda. So what it will do, within a few seconds, Copilot will create a new slide. Okay, there is some issues in that. In some cases, if this is having an issue, you can refresh the page and try it again. See, this is the good example. Sometimes even the Copilot is in initial phases, it is not able to understand what we are trying to do. We can also use these options at the bottom. View the prompts, and I can use these prompts, but sometime Copilot will not able to understand it. Like, let's say add a slide about agenda. In that case, is rephrase your question. If it is not responding like this things, it is responding, try it once again, try to refresh it once again, try to give it animation once again, it will do. That's how you can use inside this. Or you can, in case if you have a presentation from file, I want to create a presentation for file from Graphic Design Institute. So instead of it's giving me a vague prompt, I have given Copilot a file. Okay, Copilot, create a presentation using this file only that I already have in my OneDrive. Copilot will start it. Okay, this is the slides I'm going to create it. And it has started generating me a file. Even speaker notes at the bottom of it, whatever the Copilot is adding, there is a speaker note for it. Health and wellness benefits, all these. And I have given a single prompt within seconds. It has created for me. Even I can use the designer in case if I want to make it more like this, or might be this, agendas. Even I can ask Copilot, okay, Copilot, insert a picture for me on this page. Make it more, add an animation on this one. Yeah, Copilot can do this for you. And this is not the only, you can use in the Teams as well. You can use in the Excel as well. And all those application, that M365 application. That's how we can use on the day-to-day basis. And there are a lot of opportunity that Copilot is ahead. According to a study, 65% of employees says that they don't have the right skills set to fully take advantage of the AI tools. And again, one more number, optimizing, how we can optimize the time saving. 1.2 hours average weekly time saving reported by early Copilot users, according to a study. And that's all about the webinar. Guys, we still have some time. In case you guys have any question for me, the chat is open. We still have 10 minutes. Kindly put your questions and I will be answering now. And in case if you have any questions related to courses, you can always reach out to on this email. And in case if you do not have any question, thank you so much for joining the session. And I hope you have learned something new. Thank you once again. I can see Gautam has asked a question in the resume scenario. Once we are comparing it, analyzing a resume, and can you ask which assignment can be provided to evaluate a candidate in the better way? Yes, why not, Gautam? Yes, we can ask Copilot. We can ask Copilot how we can use it. Like, Just give ask in your natural language whatever questions you have. Copilot will respond to you. Definitely, that's a chance. Maybe try it now, please. I have logged in via cell phone and can't try it now. Okay, Gautam, I can try it. Give me this prompt that you want me to try in the Copilot. I'm also like a prompt. Give me the prompt, I will ask Copilot. Thank you. Thank you, GK. Thank you for joining. See, we have a limitation for 1 hour. I tried my best to give it how we can use it for HR perspective. There are other webinars as well in case if you guys want to join it for ITs, there are further finance, other webinars, feel free to. And yes, Peppins, do you want to ask any questions? Yeah, put in the chat. That's fine, Biz. Yes, analyzation of data is possible here. That's true. Yeah, let's say as you have asked a question, let's try to check in Excel. Let's say if I'm using Excel, I have some data that I use on day-to-day basis. Let's say, for example, I have some data I want to show you. Fabricam marketing campaign that we have in quarter one. I have these data with me and now I want to ask Copilot any questions. Okay, this is, let's say, for this data I have, what are the total targeted user, all these things. I can ask Copilot to do it for me. What I can ask Copilot, I can ask, okay, show some insights. Or I can ask anything about this, like, let's say if I want to change the color of this, can Copilot do it for me? Yes, Copilot can change the color. Do I want to change the dates, anything? Let's say if I have given some insights, show me some insights. Copilot will give you some insight. Even they inform me what is this insight is all about. I can add to a new sheet and I can see, okay, this is the new sheet from where the date is. Can I ask more insight for the Copilot? Can I see another insight? Yeah, see another site. I can add this to another sheet. This is this one. Can I ask Copilot for another insight? Yes, Copilot. So ask in your questions and Copilot will do it for me. All these. Now I have different sheets at the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4. I want to combine those into one. I will do add all insights to one. And Copilot will add all those insights that we have created into one grid. And this is what it is. This is how it looks like. So that's how you can ask. Use your natural language, ask the questions, and Copilot will respond it for you. Gautam, please help me design an activity-based assignment for this resume. Okay. So what you want to do, this is prompt for Copilot inside the Word. You want to use it on this resume. This is the comparison between those. You want to, on this comparison between, you want to ask a question based on this one? This is the new option as well. Add the suggested images. Okay, let's try. I have selected those. So what I will do, I will ask Copilot over here. And I will give a prompt. Please help me design an activity-based assignment for this resume. Activity-based assignment. See, Copilot has started giving group discussions, writing recommendations, submissions, evaluation criteria. See, we are happy with this, we can always keep it. In case if we want to regenerate it, Copilot has always given us. And every time Copilot will try to give you some options, portfolios, team collaboration, in case if you will give Copilot more responses. Okay, I have 30 minutes to do this. Give me a certain thing that I can do in 30 minutes, any activity I can perform in 30 minutes. The more refined question you will ask, the more clear Copilot responses will be. So guys, that's about it. So let's wrap up for today. And in case if, let's see if I will see you guys in any other session probably. Yeah. Thank you all for joining the session. I hope this this has given you some clarity about how Copilot world works. Yes, Gautam, yeah, you have to be very specific. Yeah, the more specific you will be, see, if you will give a vague prompt to the Copilot, Copilot will not able to understand and it will give you some the responses accordingly. Give the exact what you want from the Copilot and Copilot will respond to you according to that. Once you have the responses, you have always the opportunity to refine it. Thank you, guys. Thank you, everyone, for joining the session. I hope this is a fruitful. Have a good day ahead. Bye-bye. In case if you guys have any question for me, you can always reach out regarding the sessions, any training sessions you have on this info@koenigsolution.com.